The head of a nail has an area of 0.5 centimeters squared. Find the pressure exerted on its head when the weight of 5 newtons act on it. So, pressure is going to be equal to force over area. So, if this nail is being acted on by a weight of 5 newtons, so it means that the force is going to be equal to 5 newtons. Divide that by the area. Now, the area of it's 0.5 centimeters squared. So our answer we have to first convert this area into meters squared so that we have the right SI units acting right there. So it means that to convert 0.5 centimeters squared to meters squared, we are going to divide 0.5 centimeters squared. We are going to divide that by 10,000, and we shall get 5 times 10 to the power negative 5. So it means that here it's going to be 5, divide that by. So the area exerted there is going to be 100,000 newtons per meter squared. Please remember that when we are given numbers like this, we are supposed to first make sure, before we get the answer, that the force is in newtons and the area is in meter squared. If they are given to us in any other units, we have to endeavor to first convert them back to the SI units of those respective quantities before we do the divisions. A glass block of density 25,000 kilograms measures that. What is the maximum pressure it exerts on a flat horizontal surface in newtons per meter squared? Let's draw a sketch for this. The block in question, a glass block of density that measures 20 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 5. So if this is our block, the glass block, it is having 20 centimeters right there by 10 by 5 centimeters. They're asking us to find the maximum pressure exerted on the flat or on a flat hole. The maximum pressure it exerts on a flat horizontal surface in newton per meter squared. So it means if they want the question in newton per meter squared, it means even we are supposed to first make sure that this is the SI unit. So it means our force is supposed to be newtons and our area is supposed to be meter squared. We know that for us to be able to find the pressure, it is going to be equal to force over area. That is pressure in solids. Now, what is our force? Now, we do not have the force. It's not directly given to us in the question. So, we need to first figure out what force we are going to use here. So, to find the force first, we know that force is going to be mass times gravity. What is our mass? The mass is not given according to the question. In our question, we only have density. And the density they've given us is 2,500 kilograms per meters cubed. So we use that density to get the mass. So this is going to transition into this. That force is going to be equal to 2,500. We know that mass is density times volume. Times our gravity, which is 10. Now, we have the density in the question. We can get the volume because we have the dimensions of this, so we can get the volume. Now, we can get the volume by the volume of this cuboid is going to be length times width times height. But now, since we are calculating for pressure, we try and first convert these to meters. Then we work when our figures are already in meters. We make our conversions from here. So it means that right here, our 20 centimeters, when we convert this to meters, it's going to become 0.2 meters. Our 10 centimeters to meters is going to become 0.1 meters. Then 5 centimeters to meters is going to become 0.05 meters. Now, that simply means that our volume here is going to be, our next step here is going to be density. Now, according to our question, the density is 2,500 kilograms per meter cubed. So it's going to be 2,500. Multiply that by the volume. Now the volume is length times width times height. The length here is 0.2 times times the width, which is 0.1, times the height, which is 0.05. Now multiply that by the gravity. Now the gravity will become is 10. It's a constant 10. So when we compute all this, we shall end up with 25 newtons. So it means that the force we have got is 25 newtons, the force. So after getting the force, now we go ahead and find the area. Now remember, they are telling us to find the maximum pressure. And according to our previous video, we said that according to pressure in solids, the smaller the area, the higher the pressure. So if they want the maximum pressure, it means this maximum pressure is being exerted onto the smallest surface area. Oh no, it's being... if you look at these three faces, they are looking for the maximum pressure. So it means that the maximum pressure is achieved when the smallest area of these faces is the one being in contact with a surface. So it means our task, for us to be able to find the maximum pressure, it means we are supposed to find the smallest area of this. So let's compute the areas. Let's call this A, B, C. If you look at the areas of A, the area of A is length times width. The length is 0.2. Multiply that by the width, which is 0.05. And the area of A is definitely going to give us 0.01 meters squared. So the area of face B, which is that one, face B is going to be length, which is 0.1, times that, which is 0.05. And definitely right here, we are going to end up with 0.005. Then C, this face C, is going to be a length, which is 0.2. Multiply that by the width of this, which is going to be 0.1. Now 0.2 times 0.1 is 0.02. This is meters squared, and that is meters squared. Now if you look at all these three faces, A, B, and C, you realize that the smallest area is B. B is having the smallest area of 0.005 meters squared. Now, if this is the smallest area, it means that here is where the maximum pressure is going to be experienced. So for us to calculate for maximum pressure, P maximum is going to be equal to the force over smallest area. So the force we got, 25 newtons, divide that by our smallest area, which is going to be 0.05 meters squared, and our answer will be, that is going to be our maximum pressure exerted. Now the maximum pressure is exerted on the smallest area, and in that we have answered the question. The question is requiring us to find the maximum pressure. Now if they required us to find the minimum pressure exerted by these faces, it would mean that we are supposed to look out for the biggest area. So it means for pressure, when they to find the minimum pressure exerted by this cuboid, if one of its faces is to go into contact with the table or with the surface, it would still be the same force exerted by that, divide that by the biggest area. And definitely the least pressure, if you had to calculate, would be 1250. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. For more of these videos, simply subscribe. And please remember to share this video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Wangakuramia.